The XBlocPlus unit were invented by Delta Marine Consultants in the Netherlands. This is only the fourth time it's been used in the world and the first time in Australasia. So quite early in the project, we collected some additional wave data, and that told us that the waves we were likely to get at the site during a big storm were quite a bit bigger than expected. And so that meant we needed quite a lot more rock and larger rock. And it's quite specific rock we need. You can't get it in the lower North Island. And so that meant that there was going to be a significant added cost to the project and an extended program while we sourced that rock. So the XBlocPlus units are concrete armour units that fit together like a jigsaw. And by interlocking this way, we can use much smaller units and a lesser number, so a much smaller volume. And so what that means is it ends up speeding up the program and resulting in quite considerable cost savings and also a lower CO2 footprint. We had some really unique cultural, ecological and landscape requirements, and so before we could adopt them on the project, we needed to do some design modifications to ensure we achieved these outcomes.
The Te Ara Tupua Alliance was really keen to be creating a bespoke block, a bespoke pattern grounded in the cultural narrative of this project.
Te Ripowai, the rippling waters, was about how we capture the aspiration around guardianship. Te ati awa tupu arau, te auripo te mangati, te auripo te manganui, he kaitiaki ki te whenua. Under our whakatauki, it speaks of the water moving. And as guardians and kaitiaki on the whenua, guardians of the land, we need to make sure that we keep those ripples moving, we keep those currents moving. So if we look after the land, the water will reciprocate and vice versa. So straight away for me, it was, these are going into the realm of Tangaroa. We have narrative that connects Hine Moana, which is our harbour here. It's a connection to Tangaroa, so what does that look like? The Auripo, making sure that we capture the currents and things like that. So those were all creative thematics for me, and that's where the pattern came from.
And the design challenge for us was to keep that concept true when we brought the ecological constraints into it as well.
So we wanted to mimic the marine habitat that exists along this stretch of coastline. The design drew inspiration from the natural elements that currently exist at the project site. A big feature at this site is the rocky reef and boulder habitat that create these large features, and also the kelp holdfasts, or the root system of the kelp plants that attach to the rocky reef and create these smaller scale complexities on the rocky substrate.
So what we ended up coming up with was using Len's artwork on the side faces of the XBlocks and within the recesses of these, using a kelp holdfast-like form to create these variable spaces and subregions to suit the different flora and fauna.
These XBlocks and the revetment themselves have been designed for a 100-year return period storm event and 50 years of sea level rise.
So we have a 20,000 square metre site here specifically set up for the production of the 7,000 XBlock units for the Te Ara Tupua Alliance projects. We cast 25 XBlocks per day using a specifically set up casting facility.
Taking everyone's design ideas and constraints on board to create what has ultimately been a very cost-effective and really beautiful piece of design.